Let's head over to our guest in the Beko kitchen, and it's a good morning to Aisha. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks for having me.
No, it is an absolute pleasure because it means I don't have to do so much in the kitchen.
And I've got to do more.
And Mark's got to do more. Beautiful book. What are we going to be making today?
So today we're going to do my spicy chili prawns, which are just gorgeous, and a lovely Middle Eastern inspired salad.
Nice work. Are you excited about this, Mark?
I am excited, yeah. I love all these flavours. Great.
I know, it's going to be brilliant too. We'll tell you more about the book and, of course, Aisha as the show develops. Okay, looking forward to seeing how we put it all together. Okay, it is a big welcome to the cafe, Aisha.
Hello again.
Okay, well, we got the first part out of the way. Now here's the important part. This is the actual making of it. Usually I just step back and let the guest help Mark, because Mark's a great chef. You're a great chef. I'm sure this is going to be brilliant. So we are making spicy chili prawns from your beautiful book.
Yes.
Congratulations on the book, by
the way.
Thank you. How many recipes in it?
There's over 90.
Over 90? That is value for money. Okay, cool. 89 more to make, but let's get the first one underway. Just a little bit about your background while Mark's doing the first stages.
Yeah, so I was born and brought up in Malawi in Africa and moved to the UK when I was in my early teens.
Yes.
And then decided I wanted to go travelling and see the world.
And you got trapped here.
I got trapped here.
We love that. Because then you brought all your expertise to this brilliant dish. So this is one of your favourites,
One of my favourites. It's my mum's spicy chili prawns.
Oh, nice.
So easy to make.
So you're sharing family recipes in this?
Absolutely. Okay. They're all family recipes.
Okay, so what's Mark been doing?
So there's a bit of a marinade in here. So you've got chili, paprika, lemon juice, a little bit of oil. And then you just put that away for about at least 60 minutes. Overnight's great as
Okay,
well.
Cool.
Yeah.
So put it in the fridge?
In the fridge.
Overnight.
So obviously the longer you do it, the more flavour you're going to get into your prawns.
Right. Absolutely.
Jeez, it smells good, Mark, doesn't it?
I know, yeah. And we've not even started cooking. Just eat it like that. Right, so they're going to marinate.
Okay.
Yep. Now, and then you've got the garlic going in. And the great thing about these is they don't take very long to cook at all. So once you've got the butter in there, you pop the garlic in, really makes it, you know, aromatic, and put the prawns in, and then a few other ingredients, and you're done.
Oh, nice! Yes,
yeah. Mark loves really easy.
Yeah, I was going to say it's my favourite ingredient, which we're going to be using there. So
he'll be excited.
It's a great recipe. Right, so you put the butter in, Mike.
Okay, cool. All right. Well, actually, you can do that, Aisha. There you go.
Yeah,
you
can.
No, he's
I'll just be the book model today. My Indian Kitchen, beautiful book, over 90 recipes. Okay, so a bit of butter in there, and the garlic's going to go in.
Probably put a splash of oil in there as well, actually, just so that, because butter does have a tendency.
So what makes your mum's recipe different to others that are similar?
What are always the best recipes?
Absolutely.
Recipe?
Look, I think Indian food, because it's such a vast country, there's so many different elements, you know, there's so many different types of Indian food. But I think people have this idea that, you know, butter chicken or tikka masala is Indian food,
right.
And it's actually not.
Right, okay,
you know,
cool.
So each family has their own way of cooking, and for me, I think the important thing was to bring a Western element to it as well. So I'm married to a Kiwi, needed it to all work together. So there's East and West going on in there. So, you know, I've got pavlova with cardamom and rose, you know, and yeah, so things like that. Spicy shepherd's pie is one of those lovely dishes that my mum used to cook. So yeah, some real, you know, East and West elements in there.
Is he doing a good job so far?
He's doing a good job.
Oh, yeah, good. So you're doing everything right. You just keep an eye on
no one else is going to cook. Yeah.
We're just having a yarn. Let Mark do the cook. It's like being in a restaurant, isn't it?
It's lovely.
No, this is great. Like prawns, chili, butter. I mean,
What's not to love?
And you mentioned before how, you know, India, a vast country. Mm. Is the food different between the regions?
Yeah, very much so. And I think because we're from the Gujarat, well, my grandparents were in the Gujarat and they moved to Africa when the partition happened between India and Pakistan. And so they didn't want to go to Pakistan. So they thought, right, we'll go to Africa and help build the railways and start businesses and stuff like that. So that's when they all moved down. There was a big migration.
Nice.
So that's where the childhood was in, you know, growing up in Malawi, which was lovely.
And is there a bit of African in some of these recipes as well?
Not really.
Okay.
No, not really. Because all the recipes, the Indian recipes or the family recipes were preserved. So it's, you know, we all lived in our community with sort of preserving and handing down recipes. So they all sort of stayed. But yeah, no, it's
beautiful. This is what we're making, and it is looking beautiful so far. And we will get the next steps to this in just a few minutes with Ashia and Mark. Back in the Beko kitchen, and we need to finish off Ashia's spicy chili prawns. Are you happy with the prawns?
They look amazing.
Okay, so they're smelling amazing. What more do we have to do to them?
So we just now need to put some coriander.
Oh, yeah, cool.
Coriander in
is
there.
That, and all then, of that in
yep,
there?
Yeah, all of that.
And just sprinkle it on?
Yeah.
Okay,
perfect.
Cool.
Yep.
I feel like one of your kids at home. Mom, what do we do?
What do we do next?
Okay, cool. Stir it up a bit.
Stir it up a bit and it's all ready to go.
All ready to go. Geez, perfect. If it lasts that long, I'll be using that the whole time. Okay, brilliant. So what's Mark up to now? Is that aubergine?
Yeah, right. So we've got the salad now. So what we need to do for the salad is we've got an eggplant here. So I'm just going to dice it up and we're going to roast it.
Okay, nice.
So it goes on a oven tray and then into a hot oven. And then probably roast it about 15 minutes or so.
Yeah, about 15 minutes. So this is a really lovely, easy recipe. It's got Middle Eastern flavours.
Yeah.
So I've got a sister that lives in Abu Dhabi. And so when I visit her, she just whips that up with a side of a roast leg of lamb or something. And it's...
I love this. Like so the international good, food court in one recipe, really.
Absolutely.
A bit of everything. And so do you work at a restaurant, or am I correct that you cook at home?
I'm a home cook, and this has been a dream for about 6 years
nice.
To publish my first cookbook.
So it's about sharing your family's recipes.
Yeah, absolutely. Sharing those recipes. And, you know, because I'm not a celebrity, I haven't been on TV, I haven't got a platform. It was quite hard to get those,
How long did it take you to sort of get the ball rolling?
6 years.
6 years?
Yep.
Okay, so it's a labour of love.
It is.
And what a beautiful baby it has turned out to be.
It is, it's beautiful.
Okay, cool. So we've got the aubergine in the oven.
Yeah, so that's roasting in the oven.
And then what have we got here?
And then we've just got some pita breads here. Just nice. Dice it up roughly, nice. And then we're going to fry that, so it's going to give us a nice little crunch and texture
okay,
in there.
Okay, cool.
A little bit of salt and pepper.
Put that in last. It's all just okay. Adds a really nice element to the salad.
Right, and then we've got some capsicums. And we're just going to dice those up.
So everything apart from the aubergine is raw in this recipe?
That's right. So the aubergine and then the pita bread.
Okay.
But everything else is raw, so you just chop it all
nice.
Up.
Nice, yeah. Nice. Pretty really colours too.
Yeah, really easy to do.
What inspired you to put the book together?
So for me, it was, I'm married to a Kiwi,
yeah.
And I wanted my kids obviously to have, you know, to be remembering both parts of the heritage,
yeah. Yeah,
you know,
okay,
so just
cool.
Having that sort of recipes that I grew up with,
nice.
I wanted them to not forget,
brilliant.
You know, so it's a lovely way of bringing both cultures together.
Yeah, nice it is. Yeah. And speaking of cultures coming together, everybody comes over to your home.
They do. We love entertaining. And
I never get invited over. It's a downfall of being a chef.
Well, I'll tell you what, mate, you do a good job of this recipe, and I'm sure you will be. You'll probably be cooking though. So pita bread's going, prawns are ready, capsicum, tomatoes.
And we're going to make a quick dressing.
Nice. Well,
so
I've got olive oil.
Get a little bit of olive oil in there.
Yeah.
Yep.
Some lemon juice.
Yes. This is nice and quick and simple.
It's really lovely.
Yeah, good.
And then a little bit of parsley and spring onions to go in there as well.
Nice.
It's like a safe one, isn't it?
Yeah. And do you think after putting one book out, you're going to be doing another one?
I would love to do
book
number two.
You got more recipes up your sleeve?
Oh, yes, definitely.
Oh, yeah,
I think book number two will be in India, I'd say.
Nice work.
Yeah.
Well, I love the fact you've brought all these different cultures to one particular recipe. It's fantastic to have you on the show. And congratulations. Beautiful book.
Thank you.
And I'm sure it's going to be a beautiful meal. Cannot wait to try these prawns and salad. And, of course, the recipe is on our website if you want it. Or you can grab a copy of Ashia's book, My Indian Kitchen, from all good bookstores.
Thank you so much, guys. Fantastic.
Smells incredible. What are you going to be doing on Monday?
Right, on Monday I've got a great spring treat, roast lamb and carrot salad.
Ooh.